Hello and welcome to the session. In this session we will discuss K method for proportions. If a series of fractions are equal, that is, say we have P upon Q is equal to R upon S is equal to X upon Y is equal to so on, then each of these fractions, or you can say each ratio, is equal to the sum of the numerators, that is P plus R plus X plus and so on, divided by the sum of the denominators, that is Q plus S plus Y plus and so on. That is, this is equal to the sum of the antecedents of the given ratios upon the sum of consequence of the given ratios. So let us suppose that we are given P upon Q is equal to R upon S is equal to X upon Y, then we have to prove that each of the given ratios is equal to P plus R plus X upon Q plus S plus Y. To start with the proof, we take, let the given ratios P upon Q equal to R upon S equal to X upon Y each be equal to K. Then this means that P would be equal to Q into K, R would be equal to S into K, and X would be equal to Y into K. Now consider P plus R plus X upon Q plus S plus Y. Now this would be equal to, in place of P we put QK, so QK plus SK, that is in place of R we put SK plus X, which is YK, this whole upon Q plus S plus Y. Now taking K common from the numerator, we have K into Q plus S plus Y the whole, and this whole upon Q plus S plus Y. Q plus S plus Y cancels in the numerator and denominator, and we are left with K. And we had assumed each ratio to be equal to K, and also we get that P plus R plus X upon Q plus S plus Y equal to K. So we can now say that P upon Q is equal to R upon S is equal to X upon Y is equal to P plus R plus X upon Q plus S plus Y. So we have proved that each ratio is equal to sum of their antecedents upon the sum of their consequence. We can extend this proof to prove this result for a series of fractions equal to each other. Let us consider one example to illustrate this result, that is of K method. Suppose we are given that P is to Q is equal to R is to S, and we are supposed to prove that P plus Q upon R plus S is equal to 4th root of P raised to the power 4 plus Q raised to the power 4 upon 4th root of R to the power 4 plus f to the power 4. We suppose let the ratios be equal to k, that is p upon q is equal to r upon s is equal to k. From here we have t is equal to qk, r is equal to sk. Now we will consider the LHS, which is p plus q upon r plus s. Now in place of p we put qk and in place of r we put sk. So now taking q common in the numerator, q into k plus 1 the whole, upon taking s common in the denominator, we have s into k plus 1 the whole. Now these cancel with each other and we are left with q upon s. So we have the LHS as q upon s. In the same way, let us now consider the RHS, which is 4th root of p to the power 4 plus q to the power 4 upon 4th root of r to the power 4 plus s to the power 4. Now, in place of p we put qk and in place of r we put sk. So we have 4th root of q to the power 4 into k to the power 4 plus q to the power 4 upon 4th root of s to the power 4 into k to the power 4 plus s to the power 4. Now we can take 4th root of q to the power 4 common from the numerator. So we have q into 4th root of k to the power 4 plus 1, this whole upon taking 4th root of s to the power 4 common in the numerator, we have s into 4th root of k to the power 4 plus 1. Now these cancel and so we have q upon s, which is same as the LHS. Thus we have the LHS is equal to the RHS, and hence we have proved the required result. Now we will discuss application of K method to continued proportions. Let us consider an example for this. If we have PQ RS RN continued proportion, then we need to prove that p to the power 4 is to q to the power 4 is equal to p minus q whole to the power 4 is to q minus r whole to the power 4. Now as p, q, r and s are in continued proportion, then p upon q is equal to q upon r is equal to r upon s. And we suppose let each of these ratios be equal to k. So from here we have p is equal to qk, q is equal to rk and r is equal to sk. Now in place of r here we will put sk, so we get q is equal to sk square, and in place of q we put sk square here, so we get p equal to sk cube. So we have p equal to sk cube, q equal to sk square and r equal to sk. Now we need to prove this. So first of all we will consider the LHS, which is p to the power 4 is to q to the power 4, that is p to the power 4 upon q to the power 4. Now in place of p we will put sk cube, So this is equal to s to the power 4 into k to the power 12 just upon q to the power 4, that is sk square to the power 4, which is s to the power 4 into k to the power 8. So this is equal to k to the power 4. Now in the same way, we will consider the RHS, which is p minus q whole to the power 4 is to q minus r whole to the power 4. That is, this is equal to p minus q whole to the power 4 upon q minus r whole to the power 4. Now, in place of p, we will put sk cube, and in place of q we will put sk square. So we have sk cube minus sk square, this whole to the power 4, upon in place of q we have sk square minus in place of r we have sk, this whole to the power 4. Now taking sk square whole to the power 4 common in the numerator, we have this into k minus 1 whole to the power 4, this upon taking sk whole to the power 4 common in the denominator, we have this into k minus 1, this whole to the power 4. Now these cancel with each other, and this is equal to s to the power 4 into k to the power 8 upon s to the power 4 into k to the power 4. Now s to the power 4, s to the power 4 cancels, and here we are left with k to the power 4. So we have RHS is k to the power 4, and also the LHS is k to the power 4. That means we now have LHS is equal to the RHS. Hence, we have proved the given result. So this is how K method is applied in case of continued proportions. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of K method in proportions.